We're nearly a week into the spring sports postseason, but with the multitude of postponements due to weather over the past 2 weeks, many teams are still scheduling makeup games to finish up their conference schedules. That was the case tonight in New Concord. The second-ranked John Glenn Muskies entered the night with a 27-0 record, one away from perfection, and they would have the chance to earn win number 28 against a very solid Philo Lady Electrics team. Let's head out to New Concord. The Lady Muskies looking for one more win to cap off their perfect regular season. We'll start in the bottom of the third, still scoreless. John Glenn, Sarah Wayne sends the first pitch of the at-bat back to the left field wall, and that's good for a double to open the inning. Two batters later, Hannah Bendel, 24 hours after throwing a no-hitter, gets it done at the plate with the liner to right field. That brings Wayne in to open the scoring 1-0. Next up, Brenna Wolford executes a textbook squeeze play, lays down the bunt far enough to allow Ryan Snyder to slide under the tag and score, 2-0 Muskies. Later in the inning, one out with runners on first and third, Philo catcher Natalie May snags the bunt out of the air for the out, then catches the runner off guard and gets the out at first base for the double play to end the inning. Top of the fourth, Philo trails 4-0. Amy McNutt sends a rocket out to right field and over Wolford's head. It bounces up and over the wall for the ground rule double, but she would end up stranded on base. Top of the fifth, Philo trails 5-0. Brooklyn Farrell opens the inning with a liner to left center to put a runner on first. Two batters later, Caitlin Rose lines one out to center field, and that's deep enough for Farrell to score, and the Electrics are on the board. Later in the inning, McNutt sends a grounder past the third baseman and brings in another run, and Philo trails 5-2. Bottom of the fifth, first pitch, Abby Buchtel absolutely demolishes this ball all the way out over the center field wall for the home run, and the Muskies increase their lead back to 4. Bottom six, Olivia Booth looks to join the home run club herself with a ball to deep, deep center, but Zoe Dawson reaches up for the robbery. Booth is out, but John Glenn adds another run on the sac fly to make it 10-2. That would be more than enough as the John Glenn Muskies cap off their regular season with a 10-2 win over the Philo Electrics. 28-0 regular season for the Lady Muskies, who will host Morgan in a district semifinal matchup Monday night at Maysville High School.